Hello, everybody. This is Tony Felker with the Frisco Chamber again. And no, we are not at Norma's, actually. We are practicing social distancing. But I do want to remind everybody, with my virtual background, please go out and support your local businesses and restaurants that are struggling right now. Whether they be a restaurant or other entities that are struggling, please go out and support them. So that's my message here as I'm using my virtual background. Here at the Conversations with the Chamber, we've been taking a lot of the issues that we're fighting through this COVID-19 crisis, trying to break them down into bits that'll help our business community understand what is going on, what the possible relief measures are out there, and help you make decisions in a prudent, smart way so that you don't overreact, but you make good decisions going forward in terms of how to deal with this issue relating to payroll, your business, taxes, benefits, etc. So joining me again today is Mr. Chris Lee, our Governmental Affairs Relations Manager. Welcome back, Chris.
Howdy.
And we have our guest with us today, Mr. Rich Allen, and he will be talking to us a little bit from Tour the Profit. But first, Chris, can you just give us a little bit of an update for those who may not have been following recently, kind of where we're at right now as it relates to the last week or two?
Yeah, so in the last few weeks, we've gone through, and by we, I think it's the entire business community and nation have been following along what Congress has been doing in light of this global pandemic and how we're addressing it. But one of the things that we're following very closely is what Congress is doing in their various actions. We've been following phase one, phase two, and phase three, different pieces of legislation that have all come out of D.C. Each one had a different approach. Phase one was medical supplies and testing supplies. Phase two talked about paid sick leave, and phase three was this big one most recently that we've been following, is the CARES Act. And there's a lot that is involved with the CARES Act. There's $349 billion in relief for small businesses. There's another huge chunk of money that's going to be sent out to individuals and individual stimulus checks. So there's a lot going on that came out of that just last week. This week, we've been monitoring some of that stuff. And we're recording this on April 2nd, just as an FYI to everybody as far as where we are in our timeline. So we're kind of in this waiting period to see what different agencies, different rule writing processes, different implementations of how all of this is actually going to trickle down to our level in our day-to-day lives. And so we're still waiting. Hopefully the process is expedited as quickly as possible. I know tomorrow the Paycheck Protection Program, which is $349 billion as part of the CARES Act, you can start applying for those 7A loans tomorrow. So all of your lenders should have some of that information on April 3rd. Check out our blog. We did a blog post about it yesterday. We've got some good resources on there for you. If you have any questions, check out there or send us an email. We've got some good stuff for you. So that's kind of where we are as far as the state of Frisco and the Frisco Government Affairs team here.
Thanks, Chris. And obviously, all of the information that you are gathering and Karen and the entire team is putting together, we're sharing it with everybody out there on our resource page. You'll find the Library of Conversations with the Chamber. I believe this is number 7 now. You'll find resources out there, breakdown on the different portions of the relief acts, the job bank if you're hiring or if you're looking for work, that is out there, and just a lot of information. So please let people know about that, share that out there, and go from there. As we're here today, we have, as I said, our guest, Rich Allen, and he's been proven around the Frisco area for many, many years now, helping businesses get the most out of their business, how to take things up to the next level. But obviously, we're in a different time today, Rich. So for those who may not know about you and your business, just remind everybody a little bit about what your business typically is, and then we'll lead into kind of a different outlook that you have and a different way of looking at what's going on today.
Sure. Thanks, Tony, Chris. Appreciate you guys having me on. Let me just first give you a shout out, man. I appreciate the extra effort that you guys at the Chamber are going through to kind of get it, stay connected with the, you know, the members and to get information out in the community. I've been, Chris, on the website that you guys are, the webpage you had put up with all the updated information. It's awesome. Very timely, very important stuff. So I just would encourage everyone to take advantage of it. This is incredible. This is what we need to be doing. So real quickly, look, I'm a business advisor, a business coach. I work with small business owners, particularly owner operators. I help owner operators think through how to run their business, how to lead their teams, and most importantly, how to build a business that is being run by a radically engaged team. That's my passion, my purpose, and that's what this is all about. And frankly, we don't need that any more than we need it right now today.
Yep, absolutely. So, you know, we've had several of the conversations. We've delved pretty deep into, you know, the SBA loans, the payroll paychecks program. We've gotten into the SBA. We've gotten into cash flow management. But as you say, Rich, you really kind of look at a business from a holistic point of view, the big picture. And your main deal is that, you know, your tagline that you've got on an upcoming webinar and some different programs is, this is not the time to retreat. And I've shared the analogy of cows that run from the storm versus buffaloes that run into the storm. You end up spending less time in the storm if you actually run into it. So tell us a little bit about what your perspective is and why this is not the time to retreat, but rather to push forward.
Yeah, Tony, if there's ever a time for strong leadership, it's right now. And, you know, here's the reality of what we're facing here, particularly in the North Texas and the Frisco area. For years, we've had perhaps the hottest economy in the country. And it hasn't really been challenging or difficult to grow or build a business here over the past several years. In fact, if you wanted to be in business anywhere, this is the place you wanted to be, because everything was happening right here in our corridor. And so part of the concern is that we, you know, when things are going really well, we tend to get a little soft. We tend to get a little complacent. People walk into our shops or come do transactions with us without us really having to do much. And so now everything's on hold. And the question is, are we ready for that? And are we doing the right things? Are we taking the right actions? A lot of times, you know, when you're put under pressure on a constant basis, a little bit more pressure doesn't hurt. But when you're not under pressure and then all of a sudden pressure comes, the question is, do you have what it takes? And I think that's the question that most of our business owners in the area are going to be asking themselves. And frankly, we're going to find out here over these next couple months, you know, how everybody's going to fare with that.
Exactly. And, you know, part of our emphasis with these conversations is giving people the information to make smart decisions, not just to recover and get through this crisis, but in some cases to put themselves in an opportunity to actually benefit going forward. And if you're in need of cash right now, you've got loans at ridiculous interest rates, cheap money, you're going to have personnel out there. You know, it was even mentioned, and just to be candid, there are some businesses that are not going to be able to make it through this. If you're in that line of business, there's an opportunity to maybe buy out that business, help them out, but also put you in a situation to be stronger going forward. So what would be two or three suggestions that you have from a business perspective, how to look at this and how, as you say, not to retreat, but take on the storm full-fledged?
Yeah, so let me, maybe the best way to do this, Tony, if you don't mind, let me share my screen with you. And I just want to take us just a quick second and I want to draw this out, because I think this is something that that most people would appreciate it when they see it. So I assume you can see my screen?
Yeah, I'm giving you credit right now just for being able to do all this technology. For questions on how to do this, please contact Rich. So
we've got to adapt. And look, even though I'm the elder statesman in the group, right? You got to learn how to use new technology, because we got to adapt our business, right? But yes. But here's the reality. Let me just talk this through for a minute, because look, we're here today on this slide right over here on the left. And, you know, I don't know how long this is going to go. This may go, let's just say it's 12 to 18 months before everything gets back to what I'd call normal. May not. It may be sooner than that, but let's just make an assumption that it's going to be a while before things really return to normal. There are going to be three types of people that kind of come through this, Tony and Chris. There are going to be three paths that people are going to walk down. There are going to be those who don't do anything, who they just assume that things will just get better and it'll work its way out, and they're going to do that. their route is going to go something like this. And likely, they're going to fall short of when it recovers. And the likely answer, and you mentioned this, Tony, the likely answer is their business is going to die. And that's going to be really unfortunate, but it's going to be those who just simply don't do anything. There'll be others who kind of check in every now and then, but they get themselves back and forth about, should I move, should I not? And they're going to wonder, and they're going to go through some kind of a rocky road. They may make it to the end, but it's going to be really difficult and challenging. And in fact, the market may simply pull their business down. And then there are going to be others who use this to take the right actions, to do the right things. And what's likely to happen for most of them is that they're going to go along and they're not going to see the change. And then slowly they'll see things pick up. There will be others who see that improvement right away. I don't know about you. I want to be one of these. And I want most business owners to be one of those. So the question we got to ask ourselves is, what are the right things? What are the things we ought to be doing right now? If you're a business owner, if you're a leader in this community, what are the things that we ought to be doing right now? And let me share this thought, because I think it's pretty simple. There are three things we have to worry about, because the reality is there's a lot of fear and uncertainty going on. Look, there are voices in all of our heads, right? Tony, you got voices in your head. Chris, you got something going in yours.
All the time, right? More so now than ever.
Yeah, and really those, and most of the voices in our head are not about, you know, nice positive things. They're about fear and uncertainty. And so our job as business owners and as leaders in the community, we've got to focus on three things. The first thing we have to do is put our attention to the care of others. And I want to talk about that for a quick second. The second thing we have to do is we have to up our game in terms of communications. So we have to be ready to scale it up in the area of communications. And lastly, we have to help build confidence, because everybody around us is looking for someone to help them, someone to lead, someone they can follow, someone they can feel good about. Let me give you three things in each area that I think are the things that we ought to be doing right now that leaders, business owners, leaders, anybody who's got a team of people or an organization that they're trying to lead, here's the things you got to do. There are nine things, right? Three in each area. In the area of care, obviously, the first thing we have to do is we have to take care of ourselves, right? We have to get some exercise. We got to eat right. We got to hydrate. We have to take care of our mental capacity at the moment, right? We've got to be in a good shape. We got to put our mask on first so that we can be there to help others. Secondly, we need to spend time with and make sure that our family is okay. If we don't keep our family safe, what else matters, right? The only reason we have a business is so we can live a good life. And so we got to make sure we do that. Thirdly, we got to spend time focused on our team. We got to make sure that they're safe. We got to go over and above to make sure that they're feeling confident, that the workplace has got the right kind of comforts and precautions that are needed. So we got to make sure that we're focused on care as the number one thing. Does that make sense? You with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Secondly, in terms of communication, let me give you three thoughts here. One is individual. We have to have conversations more frequently with people on our team. We have to find ways like this. We can't just rely on email. We can't, if we have weekly meetings, those meetings probably need to be every other day. If we're doing everything by text message, we got to pick up the phone. We got to up our game in the area of individual communications. Over-communicate is the critical thing for anybody who's directly associated with us. We got to do that on a regular basis. Second thing, we got to find a way to get our team together more frequently, because we're all working remotely now, and most of us aren't used to working with remote teams. So we've got to become proficient at using things like Zoom and other video conferences. We got to find ways to have fun and to engage with it. So, you know, I've had people, some of my clients are doing virtual lunches. We're doing virtual happy hours, right? We're playing games. Over the weekend, we had a family game night on Zoom with our kids that are in Georgia, right? So you just got to find ways to bring the team and bring others together. We can't let this separate us both physically and emotionally and relationally.
I hate to interrupt you, but have you and Tammy and our team been talking? Because I swear she's been trying to dig into my head and telling me about three or four of these things already. So she's doing a great job in her role. I think you guys have been talking. So,
well, maybe, you know, that's look, this, I know this sounds like common sense, but right now we get so wrapped into what else is going on, we forget that these are the critical things we got to be doing.
Yep.
Right.
Yes, sir. Okay. Keep going.
And so let me just, the last one real quick here, customers. This is not the time to stop talking to our customers. You guys are doing a fantastic job of it. You got to increase the opportunity. Just because you can't meet weekly for your networking meetings doesn't mean that you can't bring them together in other venues. And so we've got to be doing that. And one of the things that we've got to ask, I think there's a critical question, right? And it's how can we help? Right? That's got to be a question that we ask over and over and over again to our customers. How can we help? What do you need from me? What can I do? Don't worry about getting paid. Don't worry about the fees. Don't worry about making a business transaction. Simply ask the question, how can we help?
And Rich, not to interrupt you, but I think a key part of that is not just one time, how can we help, but continue to ask that, because as we go through this, organizations are going to be in different phases of where they are, and they might say, you know, we're fine right now, but a month later, they're going to be in a whole different ballgame. And so I think we've got to remember to keep asking that, ask that in different ways, and encourage people to reach back out and talk to us as well.
Absolutely. Look, this is it's got to be a two-way. There's still a way to do this two-way, right? You guys are demonstrating it right here. It doesn't have to be a talking head pitch. It doesn't have to be that you're sending out an email and hoping that somebody's reading it when they've got the news on in the background.
Right.
Right. We got to find ways to be able to engage them and involve them in what we're doing.
All right. I need some confidence now.
Yeah, so third part, real quick, and then I'll stop and we'll get off this. But confidence right now is what's needed. Everybody's looking to leaders to see how they're going to react. So there are three areas I think we got to work on. One is our personal confidence, right? We may be hesitant individually, but now's not the time to show it. This is one of those times where we can't show people the sweat that's rolling down the back of our neck. We've got to step up. We got to show them we're committed, we're convicted, and that we're in control. That this isn't gonna kick us off course, right? Doesn't mean we can't adapt and change, but it does mean we have to demonstrate that we can get through this. That's the first part. Second part is business. There are a lot of people wondering whether their business is going to survive. Like you said, many may not, but right now, and of course we're standing here today, every business ought to be putting in the application for the PPP loan. Every business ought to be doing it. I've talked to my clients, I've talked to some who have millions of dollars in cash reserves. They're applying for it because you never know how long this is going to go. You can always park it, You can repay it if that's your goal. You can use it to spend on local services so that you can boost up the economy. Don't let this opportunity pass. Jump in, make sure that you're doing it for the sake of your team and for the sake of the business. So we've got to be doing that. The second thing we've got to be doing with our business is we've got to adapt and change. We may be doing business, have done business one way. That may be done. We've got to change the way we're doing it. We can't stop delivering. Now's the time when new businesses get created. You know that, right? If you go back to all the downturns, that's when Airbnb got started. That's when many of the new businesses launched, was because of some crisis situation that happened or a downturn in the community. Here's the third part, real quick. The future. Now is the time for us to double down on sharing with our team what we see beyond this madness. We can't let this madness be the end of what our vision. We may have to adjust and modify our vision, but we gotta show people there is a business beyond this, there's an opportunity in the organization beyond it, and everybody that's on the team has a critical role to play in that future business. We've gotta be sharing that in a big way. Does that make sense? Is that helpful? Yeah.
That makes a lot of sense. Chris, have you got any initial thoughts? I know you just got hit with all of this, but what are your thoughts as you see this?
Yeah, no, I think there's definitely some great advice here. I think one of the things that's been echoed in previous conversations that we've had in this series is the idea of agility, the idea that you need to be adaptable and change to these different circumstances. And I think you bring up a good point that Airbnb and those types of startups that came out of hard times, they came out and just flourished because of some of these struggles that we experienced. And so I think that really does speak to how you can be confident in the future. What's next? What you got to keep your eyes moving forward. Turn off the TV every once in a while so you're not sitting there listening to the news nonstop. I mean, it's doom and gloom. But if you really kind of focus in and do the care, communication, and confidence parts of what you just talked about, you really care for yourself, your family, your team. Talk to people. Turn off the TV. I'm just going to keep saying that. So I have to remind myself I have to turn off the TV. But to really do that, I think it really does change your perception of kind of where we are in this space. I listened to a podcast recently about the history of kind of where we are now. And it was interesting because if you look back 100 years ago, there was a very similar situation. I live currently here in Louisville, and Louisville had a news clipping from its newspaper that said 1918. Everybody was quarantined, the schools were shut down. It's just ironic that here we are almost 100, around 100 years later, we're doing the exact same thing over again. So you got to remind yourself and put everything in perspective and kind of learn that, hey, in 1918, we went through this and we got through it just fine. And here we are today. And so I think those are just some really good takeaways that I took away from what you kind of just outlined here.
Yeah, and I think you raise a great point with agility. The other thing that keeps coming up, and I want to reinforce over and over again that, Rich, you touched on, is, you know, throughout all of these conversations, it's been reach out and touch base with professionals who, even if you think you know exactly what you need to be doing, it's a great thing to bounce it off of somebody else just to verify. There's too much at risk right now. At the same time, there are too many opportunities right now, and I love the point that you made that everybody, in essence, should at least strongly consider applying for that PPP. Even if you don't know it, it's very cheap money if it ends up even being a loan, if it's not a grant. And if you don't spend it, as you said, park it. You got repayment doesn't start for, I believe, a year. It's a 10-year repayment plan. And if you don't use it, you've given yourself a situation and you don't know what may be coming up in the next 6-8 months, opportunities or problems. And I think that's a great lesson there that everybody should really be looking at. And as we keep stressing, take your time, think through these different options, think outside the box that you are very good at recommending to everybody and kind of going from there. So do you have any closing thoughts on all of that, Chris and Rich? Well, Chris, we're going to
real, real quick before Rich, I don't want to jump in and cut anybody off, but I think one of the things that I just want to echo what Tony's been saying, but what I follow on the government affairs side, we don't know what's coming next. We don't know if there's going to be a phase 4. There's talk of a phase 4, but we know that phase 3, the PPP program, is available right now. And these are the opportunities that are in front of us. And I strongly would encourage anybody who's eligible to apply for one of these to do it. It's going to be, there's so much opportunity that can come from that. We've gone over that, so I don't want to keep driving down that point. But I think it's just really impactful to go ahead and take care of that now. Apply for it now. And again, we don't know what's next. So this is the opportunity that's in front of all of our businesses. And I just want to reiterate that. So
I'll leave it at that. That's good. Listen, really? Here's my final thought I would say is now is the time for everybody to be in community, right? We've got this isolation going on, the social distancing, but it's not the time to not be in community. And even to that end, what I put out there recently to the folks that follow me and are associated with me, I put together my own stimulus package. And my stimulus package was, if you want to join my breakaway coaching program, you can join for the next 3 months, no cost, no obligation. What I want for this next 3 months is for more businesses, more business owners to be connected with other business owners so that they can share ideas, kind of share the wealth of knowledge that we have, lift each other up. And so I'm inviting any business owner that wants to participate to simply jump in. And there's no obligation, no commitment. I don't care if they come for 3 months and then go away. But for the next 3 months, I want everybody to be connected to a group of peers. That's really great. Critical. So if you're not, find a group. If you don't have one, reach out to me. You can join my group and you'll benefit from it, I promise you.
Absolutely, Rich. We thank you, Tour of Profit. You always have a way of looking at simple, as you say, common sense business stuff, but putting it in a way that is completely different way to look at it that really makes people sit back and go, wow, I get it now. I understand it. And so thanks for being able to contribute with us today on this topic. Chris, as always, thank you. I also will mention, as Chris mentioned, this is April 2nd. We actually had Thursday morning. And for those that know the Chamber, we usually have a pretty good group that join Thursday morning in Chamber Works, our networking that usually meets at the Chamber. As an example of what you're talking about, Rich, with community, that group got together, and every Thursday when they have been meeting, it's always about energy. They got together today virtually, had over 50, 55 people, and it was amazing to be there a part of that and just to see everybody, to recite the Pledge of Allegiance again, to hear the standard funny jokes that everybody has. It was amazing and so refreshing to see that, and you could just see the energy that they brought in that we all need right now. Yeah. So thank you so much for that. Those that are watching this recording, please share it with everybody. Rich Allen, Tour the Profit, is there to help out. You've got business professionals all over this community that, as Rich said, aren't looking at it for fees and benefit right now. They just want to be part of this business community and reach out and help everybody and put us all in a situation where we're recovering as quickly as possible after we get through this crisis. So thank you guys so much. And as always, stay strong, everybody. We'll be there for you, and let us know what you need. Until next time.